Hello students, welcome back. Dear students, in our multiplication and division chapter, today we are going to solve last practice set, that is problem set, that is problem set number 16. Okay, in why many times you heard this word practice set by mistake, I said, because in 6th standard and 7th standard, instead of here this problem set, there is practice set. So maybe that happened. Okay. Now students, as I told you before in the previous video also, there are 6 examples, all examples we will solve here. Okay, I write only what the given things, okay, but calculation you have to do. Okay, so we'll start from the first example. Okay, now the first example is, from a total of 10,000 rupees, Anna donated 7,000 rupees to a school. Okay, the remaining amount was to be divided equally among 6 students as the all-round student prize. What was the amount of each prize? Okay, now here, from the total 10,000 rupees, Anna donated 7,000 rupees to a school. One person is there, Anna, he donated 7,000 rupees to a school. Okay. But total, the collected amount is 10,000 rupees by the school side, and in that 10,000, Anna donated 7,000 rupees. Okay, now the remaining amount was to be divided equally among 6 students. Whatever the remaining amount, that we have to distribute into 6 students equally. Okay, as the why we have to distribute that amount, that is, there is one competition or the prize is there, all round student prize. Okay, now what was the amount of each prize? Each means one, what was the amount that one student gave? Let's see here, student. Same way you have to write, that's why I write here. Okay, so you have to solve like this way. Now the total amount. Okay, total amount, rupees symbol, don't forget to write the rupees symbol, 10,000. Okay, then Anna donated amount 7,000. Okay. So now 10,000 is total amount, and out of that 7,000 Anna gave. So here we have to do the subtraction. Okay. So 10,000 minus 7,000 is equal to 3,000. This is the remaining amount. As in the example is given, so remaining amount is rupees 3,000. Now we have to divide this amount into 6 students equally. Means every student get equal share. Okay. Now, so dividing amount among 6 students, so 6 divided by 3,000, this calculation students you have to do. Okay, I write here, but you have to solve this 3,000 divided by 6. Okay, and then at last what you have to write, therefore amount of all round student prize is rupees dash. If you solve this division, then you will get the amount for per students as a all round student prize. Okay, so do the division properly. 75% example I solve, only you have to do this division here. Okay, and solve this, and then whatever answer you got, that answer you have to write the amount of all round student prize, that is in rupees. Don't forget to write the rupees symbol, don't write RS. Okay, write the rupees symbol, make it habitual. Now we'll move to the second example. An amount of 260 rupees each was collected from 50 students. Means from per students, every students, they collected 260 rupees. Okay. And total number of students is given 50. Now what is for a picnic? Wow. This is for picnic. If 11,450 rupees were spent for the picnic, what is the amount left over? Okay, now see students, from every students the school collected 260 rupees. Okay, and total number of students are 50. Okay, so here first we have to find out the total amount. How will you get that? Number of students, look here, amount collected from each student is rupees 260. Okay, number of students 50. If we multiply 260, okay, that amount multiplied with the number of students, then you will get the total collection, means the total collected amount from 50 students. Okay, now what we have to do about that amount? So they said if 11,450 were spent for the picnic, when the picnic goes that time, total expenditure of the picnic is 11,450. So they said what is the amount left? Okay, so here when we multiply, then we get a total amount, total collection are right here. So what you have to do, this total amount, so here you have to multiply this multiplication you have to do, okay, and then you will get total collection. Okay, total collection from 50 students. Then here there last you have to write, therefore total collection, whatever the total collection amount, this amount you have to write here, okay, in rupees from here. Now what we have to do, we have to find the amount left. Okay, so the total collection amount you have to write, then rupees spent for picnic, that we know 11,450. So the total collection amount from here, a multiplication that you get, minus 11,400 rupees. Okay, this subtraction also you have to do. Okay, then you will get last, therefore amount left over, that is in also rupees. So from that expenditure 11,450 rupees, we will get the amount left from the picnic. Okay, now we'll move to the third example. See students, same way you have to write and do the calculation. That's why I wrote here. Okay, you have to pause our video. When you are watching this video, that time you have to pause and write this example same way. Okay, now the third example. A shopkeeper bought a sack of 50 kilogram of sugar, kg means kilogram of sugar, for 1750 rupees. Okay, one shopkeeper is there, so he brought a 50 kg sack, gunny bag, you say pota, so of sugar he purchased. So that time he gave the money for the 50 kg sugar sack, that is 1750 rupees. Now next, as the price of sugar fell, so in market you know many times the price of any products are increase or decrease. So here the price is decrease, sugar price is decrease. When he purchased that time different price, and after some time the price is decrease. Okay, then he had to sell it at rate of 32 rupees per kilo. So he had to sell that sugar 32 rupees per kilogram. Okay, how much less money did he get than he had spent? Okay, so here he got a loss. Okay, so we have to find the cost or the price of the amount that he suffering from the loss. Okay, now look here, selling price of 1 kilo sugar, selling price means he sold that 1 kilogram sugar is 32 rupees. Then weight of the sack, that is kilogram, weight of the sack total, that is 50 kilogram. So here we have to multiply. Why we have to multiply? Because then we will get the total selling price. Okay, so 32 rupees per kilogram, 1 kilogram he sold, 1 kilogram of sugar he sold, that in price 32 rupees. Okay, so total weight of the sack is 50 kilograms. So 32 multiplied by 50, here also you have to do the multiplication. This you have to do. Okay, then you will get total selling price. So here you have to write the total selling price in rupees. Now what we have to do, then we know the purchasing price when he buy, purchase. Okay, so now in 6th or 7th standard you have this type of example. So cost price, this is when we purchase at time, the cost price and selling price, CP and SP. Okay, that you see in 6th standard. So purchasing price rupees 1750, if we minus the total whatever we got here, this amount we have to, total selling price we have to subtract minus. Okay, then you will get the less amount is the loss you got. Okay, so less amount rupees. So here what you have to do the calculation, first do the multiplication of this, then this total selling amount you have to minus from the purchasing price. Okay, then you, what you will get, you will get the answer less amount, that is in rupees. Okay, means whatever the loss you got, that amount you will get. Okay, I hope you understood this. Now we'll move to the fourth example. Now in the fourth example, again shopkeeper, okay, a shopkeeper bought 7 pressure cookers where your mother cooking rice and that. So 7 pressure cooker at the rate of 1870 rupees per cooker, means one cooker price is, per cooker means one cooker price is 1870 rupees. So total he brought 7, he purchased, bought 7 pressure cooker. He sold them all for a total of 14,230 rupees. So the total 7 pressure cooker he sold at the price 14,230 rupees. Okay. Did he get less or more money? Means did he got loss or profit than he had spent? So first students, we didn't know the total purchasing price. Okay. Means as I told you, the total cost price. 7 cookers total price we don't know. So first we have to find that. Okay. Now see here. Now the purchasing price of one cooker, that is given 1870. Then number of cookers, we know 7 cookers. So if you multiply here, then we will get the total purchasing price, okay, of the cookers, total 7 cookers price will get, okay, here. This multiplication also you have to do, okay. Then now what we have to do now? Selling price rupees, we have to find the selling price. The selling price here, that is given 14,230. Then total purchasing price, whatever you do the multiplication, this total purchasing price, this you have to subtract from selling price. Okay, 14,230, and whatever you got the total purchasing price, if you minus, then you, whatever you will get the amount, okay, that amount you have to tally, then you will know he get more or less. This also you have to write here. If this amount is more, then you have to write he get more money. Okay, if the amount is less, then you have to write there he got less. But here you have to do the subtraction of the selling price, that is 14,230, and this. But obviously I think you'll get the, here he gets more money, okay, and then this money is actually profit, okay. So here you have to do the subtraction first, find out this multiplication, total purchase price and minus from the selling price, then you will get the profit actually, okay. So find out this and solve. Okay students, now we will move to the fifth example. Now the fifth example is 14 families in a society together bought 8 sacks of wheat, each weighing 98 kilos. Okay, so there is one society apartment. Okay, so in that there are total 14 families are living. Okay, and that 14 families in the society together bought 8 sacks of wheat. So they brought 8 sacks of wheat. Okay, wheat, you eat chapati, no, from wheat. Every weighing 98 kilos, that every sack is weight, weighing means weight of that sack is 98 kilo. Okay, if they share all wheat equally, if they have to share all the wheat equally in the 14 families, what was the share of each family, means how much wheat each family will get. Okay, so now how to solve this, look here. Now first we have to find the total quantity of wheat, correct? Otherwise how can we distribute this wheat into equal families? So first we have to find the total quantity of wheat. So for that, weight of one sack, that is given 98 kilogram, each sack having 98 kilogram weight, and then number of sacks is equal to 8. So we have to multiply them, then only we will get the total quantity of wheat. Okay, so 98 multiplied by 8, this calculation you have to do. Okay, now then what we'll get here, the answer is total quantity of wheat in kilogram. Okay, now we got, when you do the calculation here, multiplication, then you will get the total quantity of wheat in kilogram. Now what we have to do, that we have to do the chapati. No, look here. Now share of each family, we have to find share of each family, means how much each family will get the wheat. Okay, For that, what we have to do? Number of family is 14. Okay. So more is given, we have to find less. So always we have to divide. Okay. If more given, more things given in the example, and we have to find less, then always we have to divide. So number of families are 14, and here this number you have to write as a dividend. Okay, this is divisor, dividend. Here the total quantity, whatever the multiplication answer, that you have to write the numbers here, and you have to divide. When you divide, this division also you have to do. So when you divide this, then the whatever the question you get, that is share of each family. Okay, so this answer you have to write here, share of each family in kilogram. Okay, then you will get how much weight got each family. Okay, per family, every family. Okay, so do this calculation, multiplication and division. Now we will move to the last example. Okay, last example. The capacity of an overhead water tank is 3000 liter. Okay, here is also one building, one apartment. In the apartment there is upside, you know, there are water tanks to store the water. Okay, so the capacity of the tank is 3000 liter. There are 16 families living in this building, that apartment or building. Total 16 families are living. Okay, if each family uses 225 liters every day, if every family, each family are using the water 225 liters every day, per day, daily, will the tank fill to the capacity be enough for all the families? When they ask the question, if all the families get sufficient water, okay, if not, if your answer is not, when you are solved, then you will get the answer. If not, what will be the shortfall be? Means here we'll get definitely the short of water. Okay, how that we have to find? Look here. First, water used by each family every day, that is given. So you have to mention the given things. As I told you, when word problems are there, you have to mention the given things first. So water used by each family every day, that is 225 liters. Okay, the number of families, same here, like this fifth example, number of families 16. So here we have to find the total water used every day. That's why we have to multiply. Okay, we have to find the more amount, then always multiply. If we have to find less amount, then divide. Just this keep in mind. Okay, so 225 and 16. Here also you have to do the calculation. Okay, now when you do the calculation, you will get the answer. The answer tells us total water used every day. Now what after that? Then total water used every day, here you have to write in liter. Okay, this is got in liter. Now if we subtract the quantity of water tank, we know the quantity of water tank is 3000 liter. So whatever we got the total water from this answer, you have to write here and then subtract 3000 liter. Then whatever the subtraction, you will get the daily shortfall liter, means how much water they short, means they need more. Okay, they feel short, that you will get that also in liter. I hope students, all the six example I wrote, okay, you have to mostly I explain, I wrote here how to solve, only you have to do the calculation. And students, complete up to date, means from up to the problem set 16 in your notebook, solve all the examples from whole chapters. Okay, in next video we will start new chapter, that is fractions. Okay, first I will send the fraction notes as well as the practice set number, sorry, not practice set, again mistake, problem set, that is 17. Okay, so along with new video I will send you notes also. Till there, students, take care. Bye bye.